This is Unit 2, Sample Paper 1, Higher Tier, and this is Question 10. Now in this question, it's important here that this says not drawn accurately. And whenever it says this, not drawn accurately or not to scale, that means that you can't go ahead and use a protractor to measure these angles because you're not going to get the marks for that. Now this is a circle, and there are some lines drawn inside the circle, and so that's telling me that I need to use circle theorems to find the values of the missing angles. Now it's important that you learn all of your circle theorems before you go into the exam, and I'm looking now for part A. It says write down the value of X. Now if you take a look at this point here and this point here on this circle, coming from this point and this point, there's an angle going to the circumference there, and also there's an angle going to the circumference there, and they've been drawn into the same segment. Okay, by the same segment, what I mean is this chord between the two points splits the circle into this segment and this segment. As long as they're drawn into the same segment from that line, then these two angles are equal to each other. So two angles drawn into the same segment from the same two points are equal. So X is 40 degrees. Now I'm going to take a look at Y. And Y is part of this quadrilateral here. Now this quadrilateral, all four corners touch the circumference of the circle, and therefore it's a cyclic quadrilateral. Now we just found that X was 40 degrees, so I'll write that there. In a cyclic quadrilateral, the opposite angles add up to 180 degrees. So this angle and this angle add up to 180 degrees. This angle and this angle add up to 180 degrees in that cyclic quadrilateral. So Y and 40 make 180 degrees. They've given us some working space here. So the workings, if you needed to write it, would be 180 take away 40. And the answer is 140 degrees. Now they may well ask you for a reason, okay? No reason is asked for here, but if they do ask you for a reason, in this one, you would write angles in the same segment are equal, and in this one, you would write opposite angles in a cyclic quadrilateral are equal. Now moving on to part B, I've got tangents drawn to a circle. In the question it says A and C are points on the circumference of a circle centre B. So there's A, there's C, and there's the centre of the circle there. Now usually the centre is denoted with O for origin. If they put O there, then you assume that it is the centre. If they're telling you the centre is something else, well then that's okay because that's where it is. It says AD and CD are tangents. So this line here and this line here are tangents to the circle. Now straight away, they're both drawn from the same external point, so I know that that line there and that line there are equal to each other. The other thing I know, this tangent meets this radius. Now I know that this is a radius because it comes to the centre of the circle, and an angle between a tangent and a radius is always 90 degrees. Now we are being asked, it says here, angle ADB is 40 degrees. ADB, 40 degrees. And in the question, it says, explain why angle ABC is 100 degrees. Okay, angle ABC is this angle here, all right, A, B, C, so it's all of that. And we need to explain why this is 100 degrees. So let's take a look. This is 40 degrees. As we said, this is also 90 degrees. These are three angles in the triangle, just this bit. Okay, this one, this one, and this one. Add up 40 and 90, you get 130. Take that away from 180, and you get 50. So we know that there's 50 degrees there. Now these two triangles are exactly the same as each other, and therefore this is also 50 degrees. And that's why ABC is 100 degrees. Now that's one way of looking at it. The other way of looking at it is to say that this is a quadrilateral, and angles inside a quadrilateral add up to 360 degrees, and we know that they're the same as each other because they were equal in length, and that's a radius, so we know that that's 40 degrees, and we've got 80, 90, 90, add those up and you get 260, which leaves 100 for there. Okay, so I need to say, why does angle ABC make 100 degrees? I'm going to look at my first reasoning, okay, with 50 degrees there, and I'm going to say angle DAB equals 90 degrees because it's between a tangent and radius. And I've shown it in the diagram up here. And then I'm going to say, I'm talking about this angle now, ABD. Therefore, three dots like this for therefore, angle ABD is 50 degrees because 180 take away 90 and 40 makes 50, and this is because it's angles in a triangle. And then I'm going to say angle DBC is equal to angle ABD, therefore angle ABC equals 50 plus 50, which equals 100 degrees. And I've given a full explanation there. Now, when you do a question like this, if you do write anything onto the diagram, like I put this little marker here and this little marker here, showing that I knew that they were equal in length, I wrote in the 50 degrees there and the 50 degrees there. Sometimes, if you haven't shown enough workings down here, they might look in the diagram and they might give you method marks for putting something in the diagram, so it is worth it. But don't just rely on it. Come down here and you write out your full explanation. So that's the answer for that. Two marks altogether, and they will pick out the two marks for that. If the explanation is partial but not full, you're going to get a method mark. For example, if you knew the 50, but if you've got the full explanation, you're going to get the two marks.